हेलो स्टूडेंट, आई एम डॉक्टर आदिनाथ डी बदर, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ केमिस्ट्री, लेट पुष्पा देवी पाटिल आर्ट्स एंड साइंस कॉलेज, रिसोड, डिस्ट वॉशिम। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस टॉपिक फॉर बीएससी सेकंड ईयर यूनिट सेकंड, दैट इज वॉल्यूमेट्रिक एनालिसिस, लेक्चर नंबर सेकंड। इन द फर्स्ट लेक्चर वी हैव डिस्कस द व्हाट इज द वॉल्यूमेट्रिक एनालिसिस, important terms involved in volumetric analysis, then what is mean by standard solution and terms to express the concentration like normality, molarity and molality, percent of solution. Now in this lecture we discuss the classification of stoichiometric method or volumetric analysis. So, volumetric method or stoichiometric methods or analysis are classified like acid base or neutralization titration. Here, acid plus base gives salt plus water. These are the example. HCl plus NaOH to gives NaCl as a salt and water as a water. Now, the second type is redox titration. That is oxidation reduction titration. Here, these are the oxidizing agent, these are the reducing agent to use this one species, and this type of titration is called as redox titration. Now, the third type is precipitation titration. Here, this is reaction of silver nitrate with NaCl to give silver chloride and sodium nitrate. These species are insoluble in water. Or obtained as a precipitate, then we can say this method called as precipitation titration. Now the fourth method is complexometric titration. Here these metal ion form a complex with chelating agent like ethylene diamine tetraacetic acid to give a zinc EDTA complex, and this type of titration is called as complexometric titration. Now the last type is diazotization titration. Here this reaction like NaNO2 plus acid base or neutralization titration now to give a diazotization product, that is HNO2. Now these are the volumetric method, acid base or we can say neutralization titration, redox, also we can say oxidation reduction titration. These are the precipitation titration, now the complexometric titration and diazotization titration. Now firstly we see the acid base or neutralization titration. Here simply we can treat it or we can titrate the one acid with another base to give water plus NaCl. These acid base titrations are further divided into four types, that is strong acid versus strong base, strong acid versus weak base, weak acid versus strong base, and weak acid versus weak base. Here strong acid versus strong base means HCl is a strong acid, is titrated with NaOH as a strong base to give water plus salt. Here strong acid versus weak base, this HCl are strong acid, is titrated with a weak base like ammonium hydroxide to give water plus ammonium chloride as a salt. Now these are the weak acid versus strong base. Here this acetic acid is a weak acid, is titrated against this strong base NaOH to give water plus this salt. Now weak acid versus weak base, this acetic acid is titrated with ammonium hydroxide weak base to give water plus this ammonia as a salt. This type of titration, that is fourth number, weak acid versus weak base, is practically impossible due to no suitable indicator is available in this titration, and it does not give a correct endpoint. So now these are the graphical representation of acid base titration by using a graph. Here these are the strong base versus weak acid. Now so in the conical flux we have taken a strong base and we have added weak acid drop by drop. So the base having a pH is 14. After the addition of weak acid, this pH goes on decreasing here toward the zero, and here obtain a end point or neutralizing point. Now this graph is a strong base versus strong acid. Now same as like strong base weak acid, here we have taken a strong base in conical flask and added a strong acid drop-wise drop by burette to decrease this pH from 14 towards the zero, and gives an end point at exact 7. This end point at up to 8, and here strong base versus strong acid, the end point is 7. Now this mixture is neutralized at a pH is equal to 7. Now these are the graph of weak base versus strong acid. Here weak base means having pH less than 12. So this pH is decreasing by adding a strong acid, and gives an end point at 4 to 5, and these are the end point or neutralizing point. Now these are the weak base versus weak acid graphical representation. Here also weak base means having a pH 12, and weak acid. So after the addition of weak acid, this concentration of pH is decreases from 12 to 0, up 12 to the towards 0, and the hypothetical end point of this titration is nearby 7. But practically this titration does not possible, because not a suitable indicator is available for this type of titration. So the pH range of this titration is for strong acid versus strong base. The pH range is 3.3 to 10.5. In the between of 3.3 to 10.5, we can get the end point of titration for strong acid versus weak base. Like this graph. Here the end point is 3.5 to 7.5. Now weak acid versus strong base. Here weak acid versus strong base. The pH range is 6.5 to 7.5. In that we can get end point of titration. Now weak acid versus weak base, here the pH range also same as like to that of strong base weak acid, 6.5 to 7.5. Now the indicator, suitable indicator for the titration, acid base titration, is phenolphthalein, methylene red, methyl orange, litmus, thymol blue, bromocrysol green, bromothymol blue, phenol red, alzerium yellow, chrysol purple, and Kango red dyes we are use for the indication of color change or indication of end point. We choose any one indicator with the help of their pH range and color. So we can conclude one indicator, that is phenolphthalein is generally used in acid-base titration. The range of that indicator is 8.2 to 10, and the end point, or that is what happened on the end point, the colorless liquid is converted into pink color. At that point we can say the neutralization of reaction is completed. Now the another indicator mostly used, that is methyl red or methyl orange. So methyl red having a pH range 4.8 to 6.0, and the end point is yellow to red. Firstly the color of that solution is yellow. After the addition of acid, this yellow is converted into red, and that point is called as end point of titration and or end point of neutralization. Now another mostly used indicator in acid base titration is methyl orange, having pH range is 3.2 to 4.4, and the end point of that indicator is red to blue. Firstly, the solution having a color is red. After the addition of acid, this red color is converted into yellow. As like this, all other indicator having a specific indication, a specific color change indication, and a specific pH range for the acid base neutralization reaction. Now the next is redox titration. So we can say reduction oxidation or oxidation reduction titration, the titration in which one reactant is oxidized and other is reduced. This type of titration it's called as redox titration. In this titration, electrons are transferred. Electron transfer processes involve releasing of electron process called as oxidation. Any species which can release an electron, then this process or this method or this electron releasing process called as oxidation. If one species of electron or gaining of electron is called as reduction. So one species can donate and one species can gain. The donating process called as oxidation and gaining process called as reduction. Now the next term, that is oxidizing agent, or we can say oxidant, the substance which oxidizes to the other and get itself reduced, like potassium permanganate. Here this potassium permanganate oxidize to other and self get reduced. This is example we see in the next reaction. Now another reducing agent, and we can say reductant, the substance which reduce to the other and get self its oxidized, for example H2SO4 or FeSO4. Now these are the redox reaction. The oxidizing agent is usually acidified potassium permanganate having oxidation state is 7, or potassium dichromate having oxidation state is 6. Now these are the reaction here. For example, FeSO4 having Fe plus 2 oxidation state. These are the reducing agent, and these are the KMnO4 having oxidation state is plus 7 in presence of acidic condition. This Mn plus 7 is converted into plus 2, and this Fe plus 2 is converted into Fe plus 3. Means this Mn gain a electron donated it by this Fe. It oxidize this Fe and get self reduce, and this then it is called as oxidizing agent. This Fe reduce this Mn and self get oxidized, that is plus 2 is converted into plus 3. Then this iron or Fe plus 2, this is called as reducing agent. These are the balance redox equation in acidic solution. Here this Fe plus 2 is converted into Fe plus 3, and this Mn plus 7 is converted into plus 2. So this type of reaction is called as redox reaction. And if we have titrate this KMnO4 against FeSO4, this type of titration is called as redox titration. Now the important oxidizing, reducing, titrating, titration reagent. Generally oxidizing reagent potassium permanganate, that is KMnO4, potassium dichromate K2CrO2O7, iodine. This iodine is further divided into iodimetry or iodometry titration. Now these are the redox indicator, that is internal redox indicator, that is diphenyl benzidine, that is diphenyl benzidine. These are the reversible position. These species are colorless after the loss of electron. It gets a violet color, and this by using this property we can use this diphenyl benzidine as a indicator in redox titration. So thank you.